Welcome back to Let's Play Emit Volume 2. Go Shibazawa production. Yes. 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 About to click it again or what? Guess so. So, I wonder what I'm gonna have for the music for this one, cause, I decided just like, for some reason, the music I used for the opening for Volume 1, it was I can't remember the title of it. That's the problem with classical kind of pieces. They have those really pain in the ass to memorize freaking titles. But yeah, I put it to that, I was just like, because, you know, that seems like a safe way to go with it. No copyright there. Ironically, it's like copyright. Much third-party content blocked in some countries, but it doesn't even show any countries that it was blocked in, so I'm guessing it wasn't blocked in any countries. So, yeah. And I was just like, what? But anyone with enough skill could literally play that piece identically. Seriously. Just like, I'm just, man, what the hell, of all the tracks, man, of all the tracks. So for these, I think I might make my own, like, music for the opening and credit sequence parts of these volumes, I guess. Because I just really can't think of any track that would fit it, really, to be honest. Not that I can think of, anyway, but, I originally was gonna try, I can't remember the track, what it's called, but it was one song in, Silent Hill Shattered Memories, and I can't remember what it was. But it was like a piano kind of track with lyrics, but I imagine that would also get match third party content, because it's freaking Silent Hill. Konami is all like, hey, I can't let you do that. Man, why is it some companies seem more strict with copyright than others? Some you can just like, we're not even going to give a shit, I'm afraid. We just don't give a fuck. The time, the clock is ticking in the background as this old man that we saw in Volume 1 who ages backwards. Which is very weird. He was all like, how much? And she was like, what do you mean, how much? This isn't what you actually said, you pervert! How much? Shut up! Then all of a sudden, he grew hair! Well, he technically already had hair, but you get the idea. Kind of like my hair in a way, only my hair's messier and, yeah. That's random. Actually, I think, no, my hair's actually a little longer than that, actually. And a bit of a darker brown as well, to be honest. You know, sometimes when I look at my hair, unless I look closely at it, it makes it seem like my hair is black more than it is dark brown, because of how dark it is. Seriously, I remember, like, at the end of Volume 1 when I was, like, talking about the Emit equals time thing and how I didn't notice that the first time I played it until I got to that point. And you just saw that, right? These throwing clocks at us left and right. It's like it foreshadows the hell out of it and makes it so damn obvious, and I freaking completely didn't notice until it actually pretty much flat out told you. Well, let's begin. Yeah, yeah. Okie dokie. Let's do the same thing we did previous time. We gotta turn on English. Click OK. and then exit. And you to the bookstore. And of course, we've got to turn on the script again. English script. Go! Action! They're in a big bookstore in the station building. Yuri is looking over a shelf of novels. Yuri and Ichiro meet in the same aisle. That guy that was at their house that one time.
Hi, long time no see.
Hi. It was fun last night, wasn't it? Never mind. For a moment the two are confused. Something is not right. Yeah. If you weren't confused in Volume 1, freaking from here onward it gets even more confusing, so don't think it's the end of the confusing. I don't even know what I'm talking about. Right, I don't even know if I even had much sleep last night, to be honest. I'm using that as an excuse. Otto Ichiro is one of her schoolmates from junior high school, which they didn't really give a good introduction to in Volume 1 because they couldn't be bothered. Yuri is now 17 and in high school. Long time. We met yesterday. Kinda looks like Yuichi from Canon. Have you forgotten already? Well, are you so much in love with me that today's like that past seemed like a lifetime or to you or something? What?
Stop joking around. It's been almost a year since I last saw you.
Yuri and Ichiro have been very close to each other since their junior high school days. So she can tell whether or not he is joking. Clearly, he is not. Clearly, this plot makes no sense right now, because remember at the end of Volume 1? Yeah, and then he's throwing you into this random scene, he's just like, what the fuck's going on? Did a year pass since then? You know, that could be a possibility. Maybe a year did pass between that. But still, it's so freaking vague, you can't tell what the hell they're talking about with it. This is my serious face. What? But last night we... Hold on. Oh wait, no. Hold on, there must be a misunderstanding.
We better talk this over. Why don't you come over to my place? It's been a long time.
Man, your lip movement was like quicker that time. What the hell?
Just a minute, let me just pay for this book. 1,200 yen. I hate my job. Let's go.
Urges him, holding the book in her hand. He really does look a bit like Yuichi, with the hair at least. You enjoy reading as much as ever, don't you?
Well, yes. But I don't see ghosts.
What? Me neither. What the hell? That was a really random thing to say. It wasn't a ghost. Who said that? I wasn't paying attention to lip movement. It was really you. Ichiro is such sure that the girl he met looked just like Yuri. A girl called Naka Yuri and looking exactly like who he met. Ichiro, this is very strange. How many girls with a ponytail and those color eyes could possibly be in this town? Well, it's a possibility, I suppose, but how identical are we talking here? Emit again! In Yuri's room, come to think of it, there was something strange about her. Who's talking?
tea, thanks.
Look at that derpy face. Derp. A bit too strong, maybe. For sure, Yuichi's long-lost cousin look-alike person gets tea, but Tomoya never got his damn tea.
Bit of tea for someone who doesn't recognize me.
Okay, maybe it wasn't the tea he would have preferred, but still. Come on. She was your carbon copy. Just like you are the copy of Yuichi, only you're not. The moment I saw her, I thought it was you. But she didn't recognize me, I was shocked.
No wonder. She was someone else.
You know what? What's kind of random here is, how Yuri has purple eyes for that, but sometimes they appear brown. It's like, make up your mind. But she soon joined our conversation and we talked a lot. Ichiro was at his friend's birthday party the night before, when he met the other Yuri. Did she tell you where she lived? No. She came along when I left after party. I said I would walk her home, but she said she was alright. We partied in front of my house.
Then the girl knows where Ishiro lives.
She said something when she left. I can't quite remember. She said something and I said, "What do you mean?" Look at that face, man. Then she said it's like a magic word. If I say it, I'll be able to see you again.
That sounds romantic. A girl so much like me. Well, I may have a twin sister.
She means this as a joke, but unless she has a twin sister, how can there be another Yuri? Ichiro has to leave because he has to write a paper. Yuri sees him to the front door.
See you.
Stuff.
Oh yes.
What is it?
Now I remember what she said. She said emit. I don't know what it means, but she sure said emit. Oh, the plot is still confusing. The basement door.
Man, it's like it's two different stories when you look at it this way. How different it is compared to the first volume, and the first volume was confusing as well.
Yuri is back in the basement of the big bookstore. The door is hidden behind piles of books.
Yes, do you really need to stay on that sentence for that long?
Jeez, as the heavy steel door opens, a sweet fragrance comes in, and it is the same scent. Yuri turns around to make sure there's no one following and goes in through the door. Yuri's standing on a dirt ground just inside the door. This is her second visit yet. Now that she has heard the word emit again, she can't keep herself from coming down here. Besides, she knows that someone like her has come from the world of emit.
Why is their world called that anyway? She remembers that the boy once told her that she looked like his mother. Tell me one thing before you go.
Do I remind you of anyone you know? Yes, my mother.
Seriously, I know it's time I'm backwards and that things are reversed there, but still.
The girl Ichiro met and thought to be Yuri may have been his mother. She hesitates for a moment, but crouches down to wipe away the dust on the ground. The same old wooden door comes through. Yuri remembers how she opened the door last time.
She picks up a small stone and writes Emit on the door. Wait a second, if maybe time has passed by a year now, how the hell did she even remember that? I would have thought she'd forget something like that. Not the whole thing, but that at least. Now the door's ready to open. Yuri holds the iron pull ring on it. She takes a deep breath and pulls the door up with all her strength. Surprise! Motherfucker. All of a sudden, the door is thrown open and she falls back. Ouch! How come it's so easy this time? To Yuri? She looks through the doorway and sees a mirror. There she finds her own face. A moment later, she realizes that it isn't a mirror. To her amazement, she finds there's another face exactly like hers looking at her from inside, and she awkwardly made her way up. It's so unexpected that she doesn't know what to do. Well, hello. Yeah, are you? Hi. Good to see you here. Blink of an eye, the girl seizes Yuri by the arm and pulls her through the pole into the unknown depths. Yuri falls to the ground and faints.
Oh, that hurts.
Well, no shit, that must have been quite a fall. It's all dark.
What happened to me?
You were thrown down the thingamajig. She remembers that a girl looked exactly like her pulled her into the hole. It's dark up above and the door above her looks closed. She feels she's fallen quite a distance.
I met that girl up there. There must be a ladder or something.
You know, why do I read this in that way? Sometimes I read it in the voice I gave her, and then other times just read it as myself. Just like, make up your mind.
But I can't see a thing.
A dim light comes from far ahead in the tunnel.
That's where the other world lies.
Yuri hesitates for a moment. But she soon realizes there's no use just sitting there, because she can't get out of the hole.
I'll go.
She cheers herself up and slowly makes her way through the tunnel. Keyword slowly, the tunnel seems to go downhill and becomes deeper. As she moves on, the fragrance grows stronger. But she keeps pausing every time. That was because of a chapter. The other world. Finally, she finds herself at the bottom of a vacant pit. Or I have daylight shining down. I don't see daylight shining down. There is nothing she can use to get to the top.
What can I do?
Well, don't just awkwardly pose. Oh! Suddenly, the ground starts to move upwards, and it lifts her up to the top of the pit. Very slowly. Very, very, very slowly, I might add. It feels just like an elevator. The slowest elevator in the world. The exit on the other side might be like this, too. Seriously, that thing's broken. Someone should fix that. The ground comes to a gentle stop, and she finds herself in a small room with a door right in front of her. Slowly, Yuri opens the door. And then... So, you're back. In front of her are two men in uniform like policemen. We've been waiting for you.
What?
It is a serious offense to go over to the other world without permission. Didn't you know that? As she tries to explain, she feels something sting her arm and she passes out. I wonder who's more confused by the plot. Anyone watching, paying attention to the plot, or Yuri herself? She's probably equally like, what the fuck is going on? Reunion. She's coming too. This is a familiar voice. Who could it be? I don't know, because I voice act every character. Light is getting into Yuri's eyes. She gradually focuses on her surroundings. She finds herself lying somewhere new. It's fairly comfortable lying there. She blinks and looks around. Doesn't look comfortable though. Are you all right, Mum?
Mum?
How could I be this old man's mum? She's just like, what the fuck? She's offended and about to protest. But she remembers that in this world, old men become young as they grow up.
Oh!
This man must be the boy she helped come back to the world, and this must be his younger days. You are the... Wait a second, so basically when he arrived back there as a kid, did he automatically age back to that? It must be. Shh! Please pretend that you're my mother. Otherwise we won't be able to get out of here. The room seems like a holding place for keeping somebody who is under arrest. What shall I do? Leave it to me. Just pretend you don't know anything. Because technically you don't. They're coming. Look at that face, just like, it's all good, man, it's all good. I'm just gonna stand you awkwardly till the next lines come up for it. The door opens. Oh, that was very slow of you. The two men in uniform come in. Are you sure she's your mother? Yes, she's my mother. Can you tell by this smile, this face? I'm sorry she caused you trouble. Well, she can go this time. From now on, be careful. I'm terribly sorry. No, that's disappointing. Maybe she is too old. Yuri is offended, but she doesn't show it. Oh yeah? Well, what's that face for then? I meant by like, well, disappointing. I was hoping the guy with the sunglasses would have a line or something like that, so I could just randomly just give him the Echo the Dolphin voice, because it'd be so random and out of nowhere. Damn it. She knows she is in the other world. But it is still unkind and even strange for a girl of 17 to be called old. Well, some people, kids in particular, would call someone in a freaking mid-20s or something old. Ridiculous. Frankly, she is set free. Once she's out, she's puzzled. She was puzzled while she was there, though. because what she sees there is just what she is used to seeing in her own world. Cars running, people walking to and fro, and the blue sky up above. Look at his face.
Is this where you live?
That's right. My name is Ken. You are Julia.
Julia. That's your mother's name, right?
Right. For now, let's just go home.